Hello everyone. On one of my previous videos, somebody asked if I could do a basic how to use video for the DSO138, so that's what I'm going to do here today. To start off here, you're going to need a battery or a power supply that is between 8 and 12 volts. Now JYE Tech does sell a little converter board, a little step-up power supply that you can plug a source that's less than 9 volts and you will get 9 volts on the output. It is actually designed for attaching to their oscilloscope, and I think there's a couple other little kits that they have that this works with. So next up here we have the switches on the left side. This is the coupling switch. So this is where you set whether or not you're measuring DC, AC, or if you want to isolate the input completely, you switch it to ground. Then we have two sensitivity settings. You have sensitivity 1, which determines whether it's 1 volt, 0.1 volts or 10 millivolts. Then you have sense 2, which is the multiplier. These two switches to adjust the sensitivity and set how many divisions for the voltage you want. Of course, 1 times 1 is going to be 1, 1 times 2 will be 2 volts, 1 times 5 will be 5 volts, and so on. Then on this side here, you have the regular buttons. So you have the select button. So this will select the parameter to be adjusted. You have the OK button, which is of course the confirmation button. We have the plus and minus buttons, which of course adjust the parameter selected by the select switch. And down here we have the reset button. And the reset button just cycles the power for the whole DSO. The handy thing for calibrating this oscilloscope is that it does have a little loop here that is a 1 kilohertz, 3.3 volt signal. So that's good for adjusting these trimmer capacitors here. And these capacitors help with the over and the under spikes. So you want a stable waveform like it's produced by this, and then you can adjust these potentiometers to make sure that the overshoot and undershoot are as close to non-existent as possible. Now that we've taken a look at the hardware there, we'll turn it on, and this will be what it will look like when you first turn it on, very first time. I reset it to the factory defaults. The good thing is if you do ever need to reset it to the factory defaults, you just hold down the plus and the minus buttons at the same time for about 2 seconds and it resets. So now to make sure that this line here is where it's supposed to be, we switch the coupling to ground and we press the select button until we get to the vertical selector, and then we hold down the OK button. And you can see that just moved the trace up to the selector. So that lined up the trace and the actual vertical selection. So one feature this does have is if you select the trigger selector, you hold the OK button for 2 seconds, it will actually place the trigger in the middle of the waveform. So that's the auto center for the trigger level. There's not a whole ton of overshoot and there's not a whole ton of undershoot, but if you do have big spikes, this is where these adjustable capacitors come into play. So you set it to DC, 0.1 volts, 5 times multiplier, then a time base of 0.1 or 0.2 milliseconds, and then you adjust those capacitors until you have a fairly smooth level waveform. Now with the time base here selected, what we can also do is we can turn on the readout, which you do by just holding down the OK button for about 2 seconds, and then the readout comes up here, and that's going to show you the Vmax, the Vmin, the average voltage, voltage peak to peak, and voltage RMS. So on the left here you can see that it tells you the frequency, the duty cycle, and all of that information when you have the readout on. Now this information basically will only work if you can manage to get a stable triggering waveform. If your waveform is jumping all over the place, then this side of the information is very useless or will be blank. This can still be helpful because it tells you the voltage maximums and all of those good things. The next feature of this oscilloscope is that it has memory, so you can save a waveform. And in order to do that, press the select button and the plus button simultaneously. And it comes up and says saving. Then what we can do is press the select and minus buttons. And you'll see it loaded in the saved waveform. Now if you select the horizontal position and say you moved it around a bunch and you need to get it back to the center, you can just make sure that the horizontal position indicator is selected and hold down the OK button for 2 seconds and it will reset it back to the center. You can see here that the vertical position indicator and the waveform have kind of jumped out of sync again. They're not lined up. So I find it's good practice to, in between each reading, basically come back to this ground state, make sure that the vertical position's selected, and then just reset it. Because it can get a little bit confusing trying to match up the line when it's not directly in line with the indicator. You have three trigger modes. So in auto mode, the oscilloscope will perform display refreshes whether the trigger happens or not. When a trigger is detected, the display will reference the trigger points. Otherwise, it'll just display the waveform at random points. In normal mode, the oscilloscope will only perform a display refresh when there are triggers. If no triggers happen, then the waveform display will just stay frozen. And then finally, you have single mode, which is the same as normal mode, except that the oscilloscope enters a hold state when it detects a trigger. You can set it to trigger either on a falling edge or a rising edge of a waveform. So that's pretty much all there is to the oscilloscope. So hopefully this video was helpful or interesting. Don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends if you want. If you haven't already, then please consider subscribing to my channel. Every subscriber helps, and I make these videos for you guys because you're awesome. If you have any questions or comments, then please leave them in the section below, or you can email them to me or tweet them to me. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day.